Thank you for the good job.
The last time John Pombe Magufuli was seen in public, he was carrying out official duties and not wearing a mask. Not long into his second term in office, he suddenly vanished from public sight. After 3 weeks of speculation came the announcement from Vice President Samia Suluhu Hassan on state television.
We lost our leader, President of the Republic of Tanzania, the Honorable Dr. John Pombe Joseph Magufuli, who parted this life from heart complications in hospital in Dar es Salaam.
Rumors had been swirling that Magufuli had sought treatment for COVID-19, largely fed by opposition leader Tundu Lissu and Kenyan media. The government denied the reports and arrested at least four people who'd speculated about his health on social media.
In all this government, no one wears a mask, including me. It proves that there is no coronavirus and God loves this nation.
President Magufuli was more than a coronavirus skeptic. His government stopped sharing data with the World Health Organization last year and declared Tanzania COVID-free through divine intervention. The official tally still stands at 509 cases and 21 deaths all these months later. He displayed a disregard for health advice, focusing on prayer and local remedies, while also claiming the vaccines were dangerous. This drew condemnation from the WHO and the Roman Catholic Church. Magufuli's COVID denial had turned into policy for a nation of 60 million.
The ministry has no plans to receive vaccines for COVID-19, which are already in use in other countries.
The WHO has repeatedly asked the government to adopt preventative measures, such as wearing face masks, to start reporting cases, and to share data. Foreign embassies began warning of a significant increase in the number of COVID-19 cases that could overwhelm Tanzania's limited hospital capacity. In late February, Magufuli finally began to change his tone, warming to the idea of wearing locally made face masks. That was just days before a shocking press conference from his finance minister, Philip Mpango, which was called to address rumors that he had died of coronavirus. Tanzania has refused to join the COVAX program, which has delivered millions of doses to 22 African countries. It will be up to Samia Suluhu Hassan to decide whether it remains an outlier when it comes to protecting its population and that of neighboring countries. Andrew Chappell, Al Jazeera.